Hello friends, welcome back. We are into the third session for embedded systems and C++ together. Embedded C++ interview questions. I hope the session is being useful. If you have any suggestions, inputs, comments, please go ahead and type it in the comment section. We'll start with the questions right away. Differentiate between the call by value and the call by reference. Which one would you prefer and why? Call by value is like making a photocopy. I have got an original paper. I am going to make a photocopy. I'll make changes in the photocopy. It will never affect the original paper. Whenever you have a variable, you copy it into another holder, and if you change the holder's value, which means the copy of that content is changed, it will not affect the original variable. So it is called call by value. Call by reference is like I have an almirah or a room where I've got a paper. I'll tell you where you have that paper. The address will be told to you. You will go there. Directly change the content in that address. In that address means the main paper itself. It's like I have got only one copy. I'll change in the content right away. I'll change the paper right away. So whenever there is a change, that will affect. Call by value will be used when you need to retain the original value somewhere else safe, but you need to operate on it. You will copy it in a different variable and you will operate on it. When you are okay to operate and change the original value itself, you will go with call by reference. Call by reference is with address. Call by value is a copy. That's it. Can you list the types of inheritances? Single inheritance, multiple inheritance, hierarchical inheritance, multi-level inheritance, and hybrid inheritance. What is single inheritance? One parent, one child is called single inheritance. Multiple inheritance, I can have two parents there, but there will be one child. It is like mom and dad together, but with a single child. Hierarchical inheritance, I've got father, I've got first brother, second brother, and third brother. This is a hierarchy what we have in picture. And next, multi-level inheritance. It is very simple. First floor, second floor, third floor. That is called multi-level. It's a very simple approach that you can follow. Hybrid inheritance, masala of anything, any of these, mix and masala of any of these can be called hybrid inheritance. It's the easiest and simplest stuff to understand. How do you use references in embedded C++? References are used to refer one address with multiple names. One function may be informed by like this particular address, say for example 1000 is the address and it has to be named as say Sachin. 1000 is referred by the name Sachin for one function. Now I can have another function referring to the same location and I can call that address as Saurav. That's it. Same location, I've got two different names for it and I call it aliasing basically, also known as is what is we talk about here. Very simple. Remember, you have two names, probably one as your official name and one name you would be normally called at home by your parents. What is a friend function? When it would be needed? Very simple and a very important question. I have a friend. I will allow that friend even to take my wallet in my trouser. But I will not allow anybody else to take. Wallet is my private property. So I can allow my friend to take the private property contents and he can access since he is my very dear friend. Similarly, I've got a private function and in that private content, there are so many variables, so many classes, objects, everything are there. I will not allow anybody else to access it. But when I have somebody as a friend function, he can access it. Similarly, class can also be made as friend class. What would be the return value of a new operator? This is a very important question. When new is used to allocate memory, if at all memory is available, if it is allocated, the allocation will now return you the address. The address from where the memory is allocated will be returned to you. And that can be collected in a pointer. If memory is not allocated, it will throw an exception. In case you do not want the exception, you can use no throw. In that case, it will return null. Next question. What happens on an object declaration? Very simple. When an object is declared, it will go ahead and call the corresponding constructor. The constructor may load the default values, whatever you have set for that constructor and the object, and it will initialize the data members for the object. It is like you washing the plate before putting food into it. What is a virtual function? It's a very, very important question when you come to interview. It is like I have got base class, I have got derived class. The function in the base class would also be available in the derived class, and both of them would do two different functions. The name of the function alone will be same there. I can do two different contents there. I can have two different contents there. For example, the base class may print I love India. The derived class may print I love the world. But both the function name will be the same, like India, India in both the functions. I mean, both the classes. The base class has got a function say India. The derived class will also get the function India. In base class, it prints I love India. In derived class, it prints I love the world. Now, we need to call the derived class function appropriately. For this to be done, I'll use virtual. I'm going to explain you with a simple example in the next slide, where I'm going to take you through the code, which is very important for you. Simply, virtual function will give different meanings to one function, which means the function name will remain the same, but the contents of the function can be different. That's it. Virtual function, what is it? How do we explain? In the interview, you need not code for this, but remember, you will have to definitely explain. I'm going to take you through a very simple example. First, I'll explain you the wrong way of coding it. Then only you can understand how right you can code it. I've got a base class. In the base class, I've got a function show, and it prints function in the base class. I've got a function display in the base class. It prints function display in the base class. Now I have got a derived class. I derived it. The moment I derive it, by default, the show and display would be available here. But I change the content in the function display and show. Function display in the derived class, function show in the derived class. Here, these two are base classes. Here, these two are derived classes. Very simple. Now, what do we do? I have a base class object. I have a base class pointer. Now, p equal to ampersand object 1. I assign the address of this base class object to the pointer. I now call the base class function display. It will go and call this. I now call the base class function show. This will be called. Now, what will be the next thing? I create a derived class object. I assign the address of the derived class object to pointer. I call the derived class function display. I call the derived class function show, and I close it. Now, what would have happened? Here, it should call the base class display, base class show. Yes, I got it called appropriately. But here, if you see, again, in the derived class, it calls only the base class function because this is not properly handled. Now, what is the problem? The address binding, we call it. The binding happens in the early way, and that's called early binding. And it will now understand, misinterpret that the function show is always the function show in the base class, and it would not realize that it would have been overwritten as a different content in the derived class. So what do we do? Very simple. We use the keyword called virtual. Now I make one of the functions in the base class as virtual, and the second one, I did not make it virtual. Now the same code, same structure, same everything. Now I run the output. The first one is made virtual. The show is alone made virtual. So what will happen? Function display in the base class proper. Function display in the derived base class proper. Function display in the base class again. Function show alone has been run properly and it has been called. Now why it is called so? This virtual keyword will tell the compiler that the address for the function show is not available right now during the compile time. Instead, it will be available during the runtime. So wait for it. During the runtime, it will understand that this pointer is allocated with object 2's address, and the object 2 has got two different functions, display and show. Wherever I made it as virtual, that corresponding function will be called, and not just the base class function. Remember it. It's a very, very important concept. What is binding? Binding is nothing but the way the variables and the function names, I mean all the components, are converted to machine language addresses. That's all. When I have the names and the function names and the variables appropriately available well before time, I call it binding. When you do the binding properly, what do you mean by that early binding? That's the next question. When all the information needed to call the function is available during the compile time itself, like this one, it is called early binding. But it will be confusing and it will be a mess when you have the overriding or when you redefine the content in the derived classes. Early binding is the one which enables you to, early binding is the one that actually gets done during the compile time, which means the complete information which has to be available will be made available during the compile time itself, and that binds things properly. That's it. We have completed today's session, and we will go with more content in the next session, which will be posted shortly. Thank you.